You're audible, sir. Yes, sir, you are audible, sir. Sir, your voice is not coming properly. Yes, you are clear, sir.
Good morning, participants, and my dear colleagues. On behalf of the short term course organized by Department of Humanities and Management Science, Madan Mohan Malvi University of Technology, with collaboration of SBNIT Surat, I welcome all the participants. I think our next speaker has been joined.
Sir has joined.
Okay, ma'am. So, we can get 5 minutes. Till the next part, our participants joining, we may wait for 5 minutes. Stay with us.
Sir will be joining soon. Kindly wait for 2 minutes. The feedback form will be shared after the session is end. So kindly be there to fill the feedback, because attendance will be noticed according to that only. Participants are requested to leave their question in the chat box. At the end of the session, we will be discussing all the questions. Sir, your screen is visible.
है, ये दो दो बार दिख रहा है, ये है क्या?
Now we are going to start our session. So I request Ugrasen sir to kindly invite sir to start the session and move forward.
Thanks, Mr. And good morning, sir, and participants and organizing committee and my dear colleagues. This is my privilege to have such a renowned speaker with us, Dr. Sudhir Narayan Singh sir, presently head of the department and associate professor in humanities and management science department, Madan Mohan Malviya University of Technology, Gorakhpur, UP. Sir has a sir is Banaras Hindu University alumnus in bilingual poet, editor, critic, and short story writer. He started career by teaching English to visually challenged students. Later on,
Ugrasen sir, your voice is not coming, sir. Kindly check your site. Yes, sir. So your voice is not coming.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir. Now you are audible.
Yeah, ma'am. Sorry for disturbance. I continue. Dr. Sudhir Narayan sir is Banaras Hindu University alumnus, is a blind bilingual poet, editor, critic, and short story writer. He started career by teaching English to visually challenged student. Later on, rendered services at various colleges, universities, institutes of UP, Haryana, and Punjab as English faculty and ELT trainer. Sir has been alumnus of 2-week summer seminar, Exeter College of Oxford University, Oxford. He enabled first visually challenged student to get admitted to Faculty of Arts and Faculty of Social Sciences, BHU Varanasi. Dr. Singh acted as resource person at HRDC, Deen Dayal Upadhyay Gorakhpur University, Gorakhpur, HRDC, BPSW University, Sonipat, UGS, UGC, ASC, GJUSNT, Haryana, attended over 50 national international seminars, conferences, and chaired technical sessions in them, including IIM Bangalore, BITS Pilani, SRM University, and at other institutions of repute. His poem appeared in journal like Poets International, Rock Pebbles, and anthologies in the enhanced world, Poet Paradise, The Fancy Realm, and The Model Melodies of Immortality. Sir has contributed 60 research articles, which are widely published by Indian and foreign publishers, and also edited 3 books, Post Feminism in India, Myth or Reality, advanced information communication technology in engineering and kyon jaruri hai jati anmulan authored two books formal letters and feminine consciousness glimpsing india perspectives sir is centrally coordinator of MMUT Gorakhpur the spoken tutorial offered by IIT Bombay guest editor the Achiever Journal panelist member International Editorial Board Associated Asia Research Foundation executive member National Executive Committee Gyandhara International Academic Public Kesans life member the association of for english studies of indian life member usmania university center for international program usmania university hyderabad sir has make a lot of achievement in his career but it is not possible to explain all these things because of short time so because before taking any time I hand over to sir it's up to you hello
Am I audible now?
Yeah, sir.
And whether the screen is visible, PPT?
Sir, it is sharing, sir. Hello sir your screen is not sharing this time it is moving sir hello am I audible sir
Sir, now your screen is visible. So kindly unmute yourself. So you are audible and your screen is being shared. सर की आवाज नहीं आ रही, बोल कहिए सर.
Critical tools and techniques.
Yes.
I hope that you all are being aware and how to what are the analytical tools and what are the other things. And you might be enlightened by Professor G.P. Sahu, Professor K.N. Srivastavadi, Dr. Hemant Kumar, and Dr. Abhijit Mishra ji, and also Dr. Archie. In research, now we are supposed to move that how to document our well research.
Well-researched task and well-researched paper. After moving to these points, I would like to draw your attention
There is some technical problem, so we will be starting soon. Kindly wait.
Hello. Yes. So welcome to a session on writing, documenting research paper and report. And I would like to carry your journey, initiate your journey, hoping that the foundation of the research is already with you. And I will be talking about research, reporting a well-researched data. When we talk about the term report and a connected with in terms of research and other things, the first thing comes to your mind that why research should be connected to reporting. So I would like to say when you are going to represent your well research data, it is nothing but reporting in the widest spectrum. And report is the wider term. I would like to focus on that, then we will jump to the documenting of the well-researched task. Objective of this session will be, after this session, the participants will be able to learn and understand that what is report in the widest form and how pivotal it is in the professional life for drafting research paper and presenting it. What are the qualities of a good research report? And various aspects of research and report as the technical writing. And we will also move to the develop an effective style for writing reports, how to write various types of data and reporting writing. So excavating origin and development of the term, I will be skipping a few of the slides so that I can focus more on the concrete terminology. And let us see how research and report are interconnected in the wider framework. When you will look at the dictionary meaning of the same and browse it in the thesaurus, you will find that report is a description, story, account, version, or words in a written or spoken account. It may be oral, it may be written. your observation, your findings, and other things will be in that form. Whether am I audible? Please somebody confirm. Then
to yes, give sir, audible,
information
audible,
about something that you have heard, done, etc.
Audible, sir.
Then later on, it is all Oxford Advanced Learner's Dictionary 2005-7th edition says that a report is a written or a spoken account of an event, especially one that is published or broadcast. Then page number 1286. Moving to that, when you will try to dig the meaning up from the Oxford Dictionary synonyms, you will find that a report of an accident account. So media report is also the part of that well researched media report, documentation, drafting, etc. Statement record, exposition, delineation, and so on and so forth. When you will try to come to look at this term as a verb, so the latest findings bring the word about, then announce, pass on, communicate, relate, tell, recount.
Sir, again the same problem. You are not audible, sir. Sir, you are not audible, sir.
The latest findings.
Okay, sir. Now it is coming.
Why is it audible?
So now it is audible.
Okay. So I would like to draw your attention particularly with the highlights of this slide, that when you look at the meaning of the report as the verb, it talks about latest finding that bring word about, announce, pass on, communicate, relate, tell, recount, give an account of said food, document, narrate, describe, etc. Delineate, detail, divulge, disclose, and circulate. So right from the digging the data and from to the disclosure and circulation, this term relates to thesis and organizing the research and publicizing it on a forum. Then I would not go into this form. I would like to say about one quotation about research. What is that quotation? There is nothing new under the sun. So when you look at the etymological meaning.
Sir, voice is again not audible.
Sir, again the same problem, your voice is not coming.
इधर म्यूट कर देंगे तो नहीं करेगा
सो नाउ इट इज कमिंग
आई थिंक आई शुड कनेक्ट थ्रू मोबाइल फॉर
द साउंड एंड यू देयर इज सम नेटवर्क इशू
नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम सो दैट वॉइस शुड बी प्रॉपर्ली ऑडिबल
श्योर सर श्योर ओके सर
आप अपना म्यूट कर दें बिल्कुल यहाँ से पीपीटी हम चला रहे हैं, हम चलाते रहेंगे ना, हमें बताइए।
Am I audible now?
Yes, sir, audible. Audible, sir.
Okay, so it talks about, move, kindly move to the another side, slide. Move back. Again. Next. So here I would like to draw your attention. And when we talk etymologically, we find that report means to carry back, because re means back and portare means to carry. Similar things may be applied to the research. Re means back and search means to bring something out. So here I would like to make a statement safely with all responsibility and accountability, that there is nothing new under the sun. But the thing that is not visible to us, we find it, and when it is cropping up, we realize that that is the research. Next slide, please. Report a statement description of what has been said, seen, done, witnessed, etc. It contains facts, figure, information, and so on and so forth. Move to the next slide, please. Then it's a formal communication. It has been a formal communication written for a specific purpose, conveying authentic information to a well-defined audience in a completely impartial and objective manner. Written in a conventional and usable form, it describes the procedures followed in the collection and examination of data. Here comes the research in report. Collection and examination of data analysis, the facts collected, derives conclusions from them and give recommendations if necessary. I would like to draw your attention towards the language. As you look at the first line underlined, they are formal communication. When you look at the uses of the language in research, and also you will realize that there are two types of expressions, subjective and objective. So for a personal writing or blog writing, or even if other writing, you can find that personal language, personal style is preferred. But for impersonal writing and research writing, objective language will be preferred. There are different types of languages, and that can be practiced specifically according to the purpose of the well-researched work. Then move to the next slide, please. Move. Escape all this. This is not required. I would like to next. Yes. Towards writing and documenting, one slide back, please. This here our real work begins. We are entering into the domain of writing. So as I suggested you earlier, that writing should be informal, approach should be objective, and documentation should be your specified thing. Here, how should you document, or while drafting a research paper, what should be your approach? I would like to mention specifically, and participant must remember, why should you write? What should be the objective of research documentation? To express or to impress? And then you will realize that you must write to express. I would like to here tell you about four types of writing. right to express, right to impress, and right to, there will always be expressive impression and impressive expression. So you will realize that for research writing, and I would like to tell you what kind of writing should be used where. When you are talking that right to impress, you can use it in literary domains and specific literary writing. But when you are telling that right to impress, express, so that is required that research work, report writing, and where objectivity is and impersonality is required, because expression is more important. What is the content of my research? The experts or other readers would know. We must keep the audience of the readership in our mind while writing also. Audience analysis is not specific to only public speaking. Rather, audience analysis is specific to writing. Writing do carry its audience, and the writer must keep it in his mind that what kind of writing he is adopting. So the best writing method for research is right to express. Then what about the other two writing? Expressive impression. Where you are writing for literature or even advertising and marketing. If the management students are writing for advertising, so they should go for expressive impression so that the customer should be feel attracted towards the new product launch. So in the introduction, while introducing new product, management students or even researchers should attractively describe and later on. But expression remains the key part. How much impressive may it be? Then they are coming final term and sublime sort of writing for any field that is known as impressive expression. You can apply it in any domain of writing, but your target should be expression only. And when you cross the domain of this, for example, I would like to give you example of Francis Bacon, who was popularly known as the father of English essays. In one of his essays, he writes, see the crisp kind of writing used by Bacon. Studies serve for delight, for ornament, and for ability. Their chief use is in privateness and retiring. And here I would like to request the support person to move to the next slide. Kindly move. With there, Bacon also says that on the pattern of writing, documenting, and other things. What was the Bacon's take on it? He says that reading maketh a full man, conference a ready man, while writing an exact man. And that must be the approach of a writer, to be as exact as possible. Well, how about the mechanism of writing? Let us think about writing mechanism for documenting research paper and report. So when you talk of mechanism of writing, there are writing styles. First is my ways or highways. People, new researchers, those who enter into the research domain, definitely they are enthusiastic young researcher. When they find something, they try to elaborate it to the level, their level based, and they try to speak big, high sounding words, and they feel that they are very genuine, they are very original. But the sad part of the story remains that they are original, but they are not expressive. They are using bombastic terms, and they are using flowery language, and they are in that adjectives, heavy adjectives and flowery language, and the zeal of the writer, somewhere the real research is diluted, divulged, and lost. So I would like to say
that while expressing on the pattern of my ways or highways, that is definitely not a good method of research. I would not go into the much elaboration of it. I want to save some time to for question and answer towards the end. And that's why I am speeding a bit up. Then there comes subjective expression. Subjective expression is the perception of the writer. Like, think that I have researched something, I found it something, but other researchers, when you go for literature survey, you find that literature survey is telling that, no, it's not true, it's different. There are other language. So that becomes the subjective expression, and that is also not the good method of adopting for research expression or research writing. So one must also keep themselves away from subjective expression. See, sometimes people talk like this, that this is my observation, my finding, and this is very true, my experience is this. Why do you think if you are not, and they will never be ready to accept the opinion of the other. So what will happen? If you are not ready to accept the research of the whole research history, documented history, why do you think that researchers would acknowledge you and your work? Means it's like convince and being convinced. And somewhere in research writing, you are convincing others to your own opinion. Clear? So that should be the approach. So you must not be very subjective in expression. And then you should not make a sweeping statement. If I say sweeping statement, means if somebody is writing that all research done in the area is not able to look into this point. You have to browse, you have to dig the data, you have to go for literature review, literature survey, and then after that, browsing the hundreds of abstracts, and then you will come to know, and after that, you will make your statement with the suitable evidences. You will have to provide evidences for that, what you are writing. And then you will be a bit objective. Like you will say that, I say this because the past studies are confirming somewhere this study. Then there comes another method of logical writing that is known as inductive logic or inductive method of writing. What is inductive writing, inductive logic? You can find that it's a journey from part to whole. Means if you are describing a journey from part to whole, so you will begin from a point, particular point, and then you will start describing the thing and then coming up to the holistic approach. Then there is deductive logic. What is deductive logic? Whole to part, reverse mechanism. So deductive logic is very good for the research in science and technology. And most of the scientific research are on that way. I would like to give you an example of deductive logic. Suppose that you are a computer science engineer and somebody reported you that there is a problem in his computer, desktop, laptop, or whatsoever, PC. So what will you do? First of all, you will try to check up holistic things, whether power is coming, current is coming to that device or not. Then later on, you will start moving to movement to the deductive logic. You will try to open the parts, you will try to check this part and parcel, and you will try to go to the CPU and other things and other parts, and ultimately you will come to the particular point. You will reach in that by applying your deductive logic that this particular device is not functioning well and the problem lies is there. So you will identify a particular problem and you will try to browse whole lot of data and ultimately you will reach to by filtering process to a particular node, and you will try to address that problem and try to so that you can sort out that particular problem you have identified as your research problem. So you will go to the deductive method of writing. There is a balanced view of there. Both processes are sometimes important, inductive and deductive both. Like suppose that you are making Formula One car. Our university does it in mechanical engineering. So what do? First, they try to, in order to improvise the speed and acceleration of the particular device of Formula One car, and if it is giving this a particular speed and control and a lot many things. So what are the other things? How will you improvise? So first you will try to conceptualize that the whole Formula One car in the one particular matrix design and all that holistic design. It will not like that you will design its tire once and steering once and wheels other things separately. There you have to look the holistic approach, fine blend of inductive and deductive logic, and then there will be hell lot of exercise from inductive to deductive, deductive to inductive, and ultimately you will come up with the final shape of your car or something. So in the scientific or in technological research, both these logics are required. Then there comes another method of research, like probing into the question, and that comes as the journalistic approach. When you talk about journalistic approach talks of the things like WH question, looking at a particular thing like what you want to do, when do you want to do, where do you want to do, why do you want to do, and how do you want to do it. So if your writing and documentation process, writing style and writing mechanism are confirming it with WH questions, and then you are in the particular direction and you are on the right path. So you can find that is the journalistic approach. And by answering all these questions, you can report on a particular research data. You can also report on a research work as well, or a research particular design. That's what is the guideline for media persons who report in the newspaper as well. So this way you will try to dig into the matrix of writing. Move to the next slide, please. Kindly, slides are not visible. Try to share the screen again. Not showing here. Are you just go to the next slide or turn the device? Turn the slide, yeah. Yes. So we are talking of fog index. What is that research report writing and mechanics of writing? I'm talking about mechanics of writing and writing style. There is one thing popularly known as fog index. If you are talking of fog index, so you will realize that while driving in a foggy weather, while in a foggy weather, it becomes quite difficult to drive. Similar is the case of being able to be writing. So what is that case? If you should use simple language, plain language. If you are using so many jargon, so many tough words, your writing will be foggy. It will take more time to the reader. It will take up more time of the reader, and it will cause disturbances and problems the way. So, tell somebody to bring some water. So fog index would be low of a research writing. And then that fog index of the writing should be very, very low. Then language should be very simple. Then there is KISS formula. Keep it short and simple. Like aphorism should be followed. My one term you can write APHORISM. Aphoristic style is the very well-known style for the good writing. When you comes to keep it short and simple, then you should follow this pattern. Moving to this documenting report or research, what format and structure you should adopt? You should adopt that divide the whole thing, whole lot of research, documented, written data. Now I do believe that your research is done and your data is properly collected. Now, my opinion is that now you are moving to document your research work in the proper way. And then you will divide the whole lot of the document into three parts. One is front matter, then main body and the back matter. Now let us look. Research paper, report writing, front matter. How should you organize the front matter of your research documentation? So there will be these points you need to focus on. First will be cover sheet. There should be a guideline of the cover sheet of a research paper, research book, thesis or a report, or even if your research paper is very big. Suppose that it is more than 70-80 pages. So cover sheet should carry what information? Name of the author, writers, funding agencies, or if any, and the dates, a lot many things should be organized over there in the proper manner. Later on, there should be frontispiece. Suppose that somebody is doing research in MMUT, so and it is research with the TQ. So frontispiece may contain the picture, image of the university or funding agencies or even both. Then there comes the title page. Title page should also be taking a lot many things, a lot many information in the positive manner. After frontispiece, there should be copyright notice. That copyright notice, normally it is sometime in a structural design and there is in a circle like image and there is written C. So title, somebody, in some of the research it is clearly mentioned that copyright notice should be there. Then there, who is holding the copyright, whether the writer or a journal to whom you are going to submit or the publisher. Then there comes the frontispiece. What is the forwarding letter? So you should insert the forwarding letter if it is having any legal obligation. Then there comes the preface. What is the preface? Preface has the background scenario, clear background mentioning that and in which area, what problem. Suppose that somebody is doing some research to find out some medicine for this COVID-19 scenario. So what will happen? What should be the preface highlight? That it should highlight clearly that COVID-19 is a virus cropping up from the Wuhan, China, and that is there because it is a still debatable issue that whether it is man-made or it is coming from the nature or from animal or whatnot. But in that particular scenario, later on COVID-19 challenged the human life and divided it into two parts, particularly pre-COVID world, during COVID world, and post-COVID era, because the whole lot of human life cycle is affected. And even not only human life is affected, even animal life and flora, fauna, everything. It is positive for the nature greenery, but it is negative for the human survival. So sustaining, surviving, and growing in that scenario is quite tough. So preface should mention all this information clearly and consistently. Moving to this acknowledgement, in the doing research, you have collected data, you must have taken information from some sources and your family member, friends, or your colleagues, or some libraries you must have visited, or digital source like NPTEL or National Digital Library of India, or other sources like online sources or even physical sources. So you must acknowledge the source from you have taken support, whether morally, mentally, ethically, physically, or in what terms, your acknowledge must must have all that data. I would like to share one line. How should one begin acknowledgement? Like as a creeper, this is just one example. You may take any and you can adopt. It is a sort of personal and subjective note for how the researcher has taken support and being benefited from what sources. You can, you can start like that. This is just one hint and one sample of acknowledgement that as a creeper depends on its every branch of the tree that supports it in the same way. I am thankful to all the support sources who directly or indirectly supported me in this, in the endeavor or in this research. Then there comes, you will acknowledge to the source, library, online source, or other physical sources, interviews conducted, data collected, or a particular industry. Everything should be acknowledged. Like for this source, we are acknowledging our support of the Technological Education Quality Improvement Program. We are also acknowledging the support of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, FVNIT, National Institute of Technology, Surat. We are acknowledging the support of Honorable Vaishyamsa, Professor Srinivas Singh, sir, and we acknowledge each and every support. Then there comes the table of content as the part of front matter. Then table of content, how should you organize? Table of content should be organized in the according the sequence your report or your paper is having the things and you have the way you have organized. Then there comes list of illustrations, and then if table of content, then abstract, list of illustrations, then abstract or summary or executive summary. Abstract is the part of deductive writing. It's a method of deductive logic and filtration and summarizing briefing. But abstract is different from summary, because abstract can be represented, published, or produced independently, but summary can't. Abstract has its independent sanctity, identity, and executive significance, where summary is not. But in the management domain, most of their places, executive summary stands equivalent to abstract. Now, moving to the next point, research paper or report writing main body. What are the things one should mention in the main body of the paper? It should have a clear introductory paragraph, and that should not be like descriptive, rather it should be methodical in the approach that from what initiated the research and how the person is leading it, and what objective the research is going to do. Even it should clearly mention the research methodology which is supposed to be adopted by the author. And it should also tell about data collection. Then there comes discussion. Based on the data collection, you should start discussing and developing your discussion. How you have collected the data, for what purpose, and what purpose is being served by that particular data or information. Even in scientific, their laboratory experiments, researchers should mention that what are the methods opted for obtaining that particular chemical or that particular product. Then there comes conclusion. And then based on the concrete findings of the research, one should draft the conclusion. This process is so scientific up to conclusion that you cannot cheat others. Cheating others will mislead you. And you are not cheating scientific community, you are cheating yourself. That's why your conclusion must based on the concrete finding. Even if you are not able to draw some concrete result and your research has gone otherwise, even then that is a research. Somebody asked to Thomas Alva Edison that in the experiment of bulb, he was failed producing light through electricity. And 1,000 times his failure, then somebody remarked him that your experiment
is full confident that he will be able to produce light through electricity one day, and Edison knows at least 1,000 ways of not making a bulb. So those knowing, though, if you are scientific in your approach, and even then you are failing, that in next time you may get success. We find that ISRO failed in a particular mission very recently, but they were committed to the success and they acknowledged that. So conclusion is that scientific part, that honest confession of the scientist and researcher, where the data is organized, compiled and presented most scientifically. And based on the concrete findings of the conclusion, one should move to the final stage of the main body, that is known as, popularly known as, recommendation. How should and what should be recommended by a good researcher? So recommendation should be on the concrete findings of the conclusion, and one should not ignore any foundation of that. Again, journalistic approach is required. What are you recommending? Why are you recommending? When are you recommending? In what circumstances you are recommending? And I must say at this very point, take this advantage to say that COVID-19 requires a lot of acceleration in the field of research. Probably that was the ground which inspired us to go for conducting this course. And one's recommendation, and with this such course was recommended to us by our Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir. So these things must be taken into account. Then moving to the main body of other parts, and then research paper, report writing, there comes the main, after main body, there comes the back matter. What are the back matters required and what are the content one should, this is the final part of research documentation, one should say, look at while talking of back matter. So in the back matter, first part comes appendices, that is known as additional charts and graphs, sample questionnaires worked on, circulation, site plans, so on, the things will be in the appendices. Then there comes references. One should be referential. References, list of work cited. There are two terms, may normally confused by the young researcher, that is reference and bibliography. How reference is different from the bibliography? References are the list of work cited, whereas bibliography is the list of works consulted. Then there is one more term coming nowadays, bibliography. If I would like to draw your attention here, that what is bibliography? If you are working from home nowadays and using online, depending heavily on online data research, so what will be your source of knowledge? You may have access to some physical books, you may have access to some remote libraries, but if you are working on internet and via internet, you will realize that you are not using list of books, physical books, rather you are using like NPTEL, National Digital Library of India, or other web sources, and even group of books by Pearson, free books by other great publisher, Emerald, and so on and so forth, or any other journal like Scopus and SCI journal. So if you are accessing all of them online, so that will not be under the category of bibliography, rather that should come under the clear heading of bibliography. And then bibliography and references, there is always a difference. For references, if you are using printed material, you will clearly mention there are many differential patterns, API, MLA, and what. Then there is bibliography, containing the list of works consulted. There is a difference between list of works cited and list of works consulted. List of works cited means you are citing those works that are being clearly used in your research work, one or two lines, a few lines for highlighting your work,
that is so significant because of you are using at a citation. But list of works consulted, you may or may not use directly or indirectly. That was the part of your journey of the academic literature survey, literature review, but you have not directly used them in your research work. Moving to the back matter, glossary if needed. List of technical words and terms which appear in the text of the report or research paper. Then there comes index. List of various topics, subtopics you need to put as indexing and various other significant aspects which have been discussed inside the main body but could not find a place in the table of content. Like in table of content, you cannot incorporate and provide a space, manage space for all small but significant terms. It is the broad division of the chapterization sort of thing when you are talking of in terms of thesis or the larger report, then or even the longer paper. So you need to mention those terms in the indexing. Then research paper report writing checklist. While talking of this page, how you have documented the research report, research paper, or your thesis. So what are the things you are supposed to go for the checklist? First title page, you should go for a second, give second revisit, third visit to or final visit to title page for a spell check and other seeing that whether the required things are at right place or not. Then you will move to the title, check the title, cross-check the title, name of the writer, organization, date, person group who commissioned it. Then table of content, it should be accurate, clear, layout, and section numbering, and then system and indentation. It should be complete. It should have page number, list of illustrations if applicable. What should be the abstract length? How should you will cross-check the abstract? It should have appropriate length. It should have complete summary of key information. It must be informative, not descriptive. So abstract should be informative. You should not describe the thing in the abstract. Rather, you should elaborate in the literature survey. It should be informed only. And an impersonal tone and connected prose. Then comes introduction. How should you draft the introduction of your research relating topic to wider field? It must have necessary background information. And the purpose of the research or report, research paper should be clearly mentioned in the introduction. And what is the scope of your research or your report? Explanation of arrangement or report section. How are you going to explain or arrange the things? Then the body and format layout of that main headings indicating equal level of significance. All subheadings relating to sections headings. It should therefore have the clear relation. Choice of label indicating hierarchy of the importance. Then hierarchy of importance is what? Most important first. Shown by the careful and consistent use of features such as capital letters. Where should you do? Different fonts, underlining, bold and italics, where normally nowadays in a particular language research or basic sciences or even social sciences, the pattern is that only textbook names are supposed to be written in italic form. And then what are the things? Underlining is no longer in practice. And bold, so the data is compiled and connected. So when you come for indenting, I would like to give you one information that if you have written a paragraph, one tab key pressing is equivalent to 5 space bar key. And that is equivalent to one indent. If you are tapping 5 times space bar for text, moving a text to write, then it means it is equivalent to one tab or one indentation. So Some journals, they expect indentation, they expect justified format, but you have to go back to the template and guideline of the particular journal to which you are communicating your data. Then there comes numbering and letter system. view should be clearly known as the space between sections to enhance the readability and layout. Here, suppose that on this very slides there are four sections. So the kind, in order to enhance your readability, sections are properly, spacing is maintained and properly divided. When using charts, statistics, and illustrations, check for suitability and caps and references in text and positioning. Then acknowledgement of all sources should be there. Once you should revisit to your acknowledgement, including material referred to indirectly, direct references or quotation, and copied diagrams, tables, statistics. One should also revisit, ensure a systematic link between references in the text and the reference list and bibliography. The next point is expression. We should be correct, own words, concise, clear to intended reader, and formal and factual. Moving to the next point, that is the content of the data. How are you going to revisit the content? It should be logical development of ideas from one section to another. It is not like that looking London, talking Tokyo. One segment should talk about one particular information and second segment should be talking about logical coherence should be there. And the symmetry should be there of thought and idea. So logical development of ideas from one section to another content could be tightly packed and it should like well-knit fabric and within each section, citing in evidences and relevant evidences that are relevant. It should, content must be relevant. No unwanted data should be forcibly inserted inside a particular research paper to enhance its length or number of words. Then there comes the approach should be objective and specific. Then if you are getting more into generalization, means your research is not going to be yield concrete result. How should you document the conclusion? Conclusion should arise out of the facts and it must be convincing. And for conclusion, a substantial basis for the recommendation should be there. You should not suppose that for MBA student, for example, or management researcher, I am talking one thing, one just example. Suppose that one MBA student is deputed for doing, he is solicited for conducting a survey and drafting a report of that whether Hayabusa bike will be visible for the routes of Gorakhpur or not. So what would be his recommendation? He should take into the account of the condition of the roads. He should be take into the account of condition of the people, community and their income, how much they may spend and whether they will be able to manage or not. And then based on all these logical thinking collection, he should go logical, arrive to a conclusion based on the logic. Then he should be convincing. A substantial basis for the recommendation should be that. Many a time people try to do a whole lot of research and while coming to the recommendation, they became so generalized that in order to cover the larger scope and areas, that they kill the purpose of their own research. That step may be self-suicidal for the particular research and purpose. Recommendations should be, if you are giving recommendation based on your research or report, it must be based on the conclusion, practical, specific, well-organizing, and most important first. While moving to list of references, sources in the text listed by there are multiple systems, PMLA, published in Modern Language Association of America, MLA, Language Modern Languages Association of America, Harvard system, or any other system recommended by the particular journal of the particular field, may it be from social science, basic science, language, literature, or management, based on that particular field, one should go for recommendation. Sources in the text listed by Harvard MLA as per the recommended required system. Moving to the bibliography, text consulted but not referred to directly in the report, that should be bibliography. Again, I would like to remind you of bibliography. You may browse a lot many data on a lot many web, like net surfing and net searching. So based on that, if you are going to get certain data, you must compile or insert in your this different section that bibliography as well. Then there comes glossary. If included, it should be in alphabetical order. Then there come appendices placed at the end of the report. If included, arranged in the order referred to the report or research paper, that should be your approach. Then I have reached to the concluding part of my talk, and then I would like you to pose your question, if any. Here are the following textbooks that I have used for this compiled preparation of these PowerPoint slides and references and list of references and works cited. So you will find how the references are arranged, and you will find that towards the end of the first point, you will find that in bracket it is written print. In second also it is written print. It is third also it is written print. Means all the data are consulted from the printed book form and other details. So this is how you are going for referencing. The last name first. A.S. Hornby means Hornby A.S. 2005 Oxford Advanced Learner's Dictionary. Chief Editor Shelley Wemner. Editors Colin McIntosh et al. What is this et al? B means if there are more than one editors, so you will write one or two names and then you will go for et al. Then edition of which place the book is published, that way you will mention. This is what about referencing. Then there comes bibliography. These are the certain materials that I have compiled and collected while drafting this these PowerPoint slides. So I reached to the conclusion, and here thanks from the Madan Mohan Malviya University of Technology, Department of Humanities and Management Science. Here I would like to hand over to the organizing secretary that if we are having any question, so they can read, or here the talk comes to an end. That's it.
Thank you so much, sir. There is a question from Dr. Prashant Kumar. He is asking that is there any free software for checking the sentences and grammatical mistakes while writing research paper?
Grammarly.
Yes, sir.
Software available, you can install, and even a lot many softwares are nowadays, and inbuilt for a spell check, there is inbuilt software inside the when you are typing inside Word also. So they, if you will get, there are certain words they are having double spelling like Z, E or S, E. So you will find that the computer system, it's a Microsoft Word or whatsoever, where you are compiling the data, itself checks your spell and even sentence structure. Nowadays, it is quite easy to go and correct your Grammarly by installing into your documentation system, and you will find it. So that will be of a great support and great help. Thank you. We'll move to the next question.
Sir, there is another question. From Amar Nath, he is asking that use of tenses used in writing abstract, introduction, and conclusion. What are the tenses used in writing abstract, introduction, and conclusion?
Wonderful. See, abstract is like a research summary and plan. Nowadays, research proposal equates with the term abstract. But what is the real traditional practice? Let me give two answers to the question. What is the traditional research practice? If you will come through, you will find that synopsis was the term used as the research proposal. And synopsis was supposed to and subject to the revision, where autonomy of the researcher was that he can revise his own synopsis and get itself approved by the concerned authority, and that is accepted. But when talking of, so when you are talking of synopsis oblique or slash research proposal, that should be written like researcher is planning to do this. So either project, he will also be doing this. So in that way. But abstract should be written in the present tense only. And normally abstracts were written after the research work. So you can say that this research paper delineates on the findings of the research and it adopts the methodology. So it should not be abstract. I won't recommend personally future tense, because this is the traditional answer. But if you are going to look it in the modern eye view viewpoint, so you will find that nowhere nowadays for research paper submission, synopsis is accepted. Nowhere. For paper, for research work, synopsis is accepted. PhD degree leading to, if your work is leading to any degree, synopsis is required. But if you are communicating a research paper, synopsis is not at all required. So nowadays, present day abstract is the methodical form, and it is a form of deductive writing where you should depend on the present and past tense. You should not use future tense. And that too in past indefinite or present indefinite tense. Sometime in progressive sentences you can come. Like, there are future scopes of the study, but this study targets to do the same. See, clear? So that way, even if you want to project something in future, you can use present. There are future scopes of the study. Clear? Future researcher may take some advantage after this research. That's, and then abstract, and what was the other part of the question? Conclusion. Conclusion is, since you have already done, excavated your data and research, so you have already your findings at your hand, so conclusion will be in the past. Like, and present again. Like, the findings suggest, findings of the research suggest, output suggest. Clear? Yeah, you will not write subjective, you will go objective, and you will... Hello.
Yes, sir.
So you will write like that. The findings of the research indicate that we should move in that direction, or as indicated by the findings of this data collection, data processing, and data analysis, it is suggested. Following points are suggested. Then you will go to 1, 2, 3, 4 in the past, simple past tense. Then what was the third point? Abstract, suggestion
and conclusion. Conclusion, sir.
Yeah, so conclusion will be in past.
Okay, sir. So there is one more question.
Future is scope also.
Yes, sir.
Is there any more?
Yes, sir. There is one more question. How to handle the anti-plagiarism? आवाज नहीं आ रही सर की आवाज नहीं आ रही मैम सर
एंड इवन देयर आर टू वेज ऑफ एंटी प्लेगरिज्म इफ यू आर मिसरिप्रेजेंटिंग इट बाय गिविंग योर ओन लॉजिक बाय अप्लाइंग योर ओन लॉजिक. Like many a times, if in a general dialogue somebody says that I don't mean it. Clear? And if you are, nowadays there is a practice, like in the terms of excessive originality, in the terms and in the enthusiasm of making your data original, there begins a problem, like that originality is challenged, and you try to like somebody has written 3-4 lines, you are using it. So that is whole plagiarism, similarity index leading to. And if you have used second thing, that is, first plagiarism, using the data of the other, similarity index, manipulating it according to you, anti-plagiarism, misinterpreting the same and according to your own wishes and whims and choices. So that thing should not be done. And then handling that, you should be original based on your logical findings, but you have no right to, you can say, negate the other findings and other work. Next question, please.
Sir, there is one more question. How to handle self-plagiarism during thesis? Hello?
Hello?
Sir, you are audible, sir.
Hello? Hello?
So you are audible.
Next question, please.
So there is one more question. How to handle self-plagiarism during thesis writing?
Hello.
Hello. I'm audible, sir.
Pandeji.
Hello.
Hello, sir. Hello, sir.
Next question. उनको belong हुए क्या नाम है? उपला को. उनके मोबाइल से बोल रहा था लेके निकल गई.
अपना मोबाइल.
जल्दी बुलाओ. ले आओ. हेलो.
अरे इसमें तो हमें कोई बोल नहीं रहा उधर. What was the next question?
How to handle self-plagiarism?
Self-plagiarism. Yeah, wonderful. Suppose that research nowadays getting more and more critical. Why is it so? Suppose that I have written a paper and that deals with one aspect of any particular problem. If I am writing another research paper, that is an enhancement of my previous work. And if the problem is that way, so what happens? That chances of self-plagiarism are increasing day by day. And but at that time, it's advisable that a researcher should cite and give citation to his own writing, that to clear citation that where you have published your previous paper, and you should also acknowledge that particular data. Okay, what is the next question?
Sir, I think time has...
Hello. Hello, yes.
Sir, I think time is over, and if participants have any question, then they can mail...
No, we can answer one or two.
Okay, sir.
Just take two more questions.
Sir, but in chat box, there is no more questions, sir.
Oh, okay. In case of poor networking, I'm so sorry that I'm unable to take the future question, and that due to paucity of time.
We are taking one more question.
Yes.
If we are using websites for consulting, should we write bibliography as another heading or in bibliography heading?
Wonderful question. Bibliography itself is a holistic term. And under the heading of bibliography, bibliography is a subset. Earlier, bibliography was there only including the only including the books, physical books, books in a printed form. That was also known as print media or dead tree media. Nowadays, we are moving to eco-friendly and paperless university. The concept of paperless examination are the product of this COVID-19 scenario. So in that scenario, if you are using bibliography, that is all inclusive term. And under the heading of bibliography, bibliography can be a subhead. That's what I wish to suggest. If there is any more question.
No, sir. Thank you so much. That's all for today.
My dear participants, I am really happy. That you spare time to listen to me, and I am thankful to the organizing secretaries of this short-term training program on nascent research method challenges and various analytical tools and techniques, that they thought me worthy enough to deliberate upon this platform. Thank you all for providing me this opportunity. Thanks a lot. I hope that you have been little orientation
related to documenting the research data, happy researching, and I would like to request and salute those who are working in the field of medicine, working in the field of technology to make the life of human being comfortable in this pandemic related time. Thank you all. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir. And it's time to give thanks to you. This is my pleasure and honor to have opportunity. Am I audible, sir? Am I audible? Hello? Hello? Am I audible? Anybody can hear me? Hello? Hello. Am I audible?
हाँ सर बट बोलिए आपकी आवाज आ रही
है या थैंक यू दिस इज माय प्लेजर एंड ऑनर टू हैव अपॉर्चुनिटी टू से थैंकिंग आवर एमिनेंट एक्सपर्ट ऑफ द सेशन ऑन राइटिंग डॉक्यूमेंटिंग रिसर्च पेपर डॉक्टर एच एन सिंह सर और HOD of the Department of Humanities and Management Science, Madan Mohan Malviya University of Technology. Sir, you have smoothly cleared to the participant writing and documenting research paper. Sir, you have well explained motive of writing research paper. It is expression or impression. You have well cleared mechanism of writing, fog index, simplex, simple language. You have also explained research paper report writing, front matter like cover page, title page, and etc. Main book of research writing, introduction, discussion, conclusion, and etc. You have well explained the use of references and bibliography, sir. All the sequences which must be considered while writing research paper. Once again, I very thankful for giving time to us. And it is your motivation that we have conducted such a wonderful short-term course. It's all about you, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much. And all the participants and organizing committee, thank you. And we will shortly join tomorrow at 10 a.m. and all the participants are required to join before 10 minutes of the session. Thank you.
It is for information to all the participants that tomorrow's session will start at 10:20, so kindly join us at 10:20 a.m. in morning.
Thank you.